or know how to coach. Superior Mark will train you. All we need are spirit-filled, willing hearts.
Yeah, I'll train you, okay?
Amen. We are also looking for volunteers who can be assessors and developers of plans for the CMCs. You do not need to also have any experience. You will be trained for these positions. And they are not paid positions, they're just volunteer positions. As part of the annual conference, or annual report of the Ministerial Education and Guidance Board to the Sierra Pacific Conference, you will have opportunity to affirm the reception of new elders by transfer to be ordained, and 10 new conference ministerial candidates saying yes to the call of God upon their lives for ministry. Mr. Chair.
Would you like the conference to take action on the Hispanic formation of the Hispanic Meg Board?
Yes, please.
Okay, so you have heard the rationale from your Meg Chair about the establishment of a Spanish-speaking sub-Meg Board working under the authority of your Meg Board. So that's a recommendation coming to us. Any question about that? Yes.
I'm just curious. Was our brother Curtis Fleming, not mentioned in this report, requested for a transfer or the status of it?
Yeah, that's a good question, but there's a motion on the floor related to the establishment of Hispanic Meg Board, so let's come back to that. Yeah, no problem. Any questions about the establishment of the Hispanic Meg Board? Yes.
How would they interact with the MAC?
Just
like the MEG board interacts with the MAC, actually some of the members of the Hispanic MEG board are going to be members of the MAC. And so they are also very close in relationship.
Okay, other questions? All right, hearing none then, those in favor of this motion, would you simply raise the hand? All right, both hands, thank you, Mark. Any opposed? And the motion is approved, thank you.
That's really huge, by the way.
Okay. A report. The 2021 report of the Ministerial Education and Guidance Board to the Sierra Pacific Conference annual conference. Mr. Chair, the Ministerial Education and Guidance Board recommends that the following persons be received by transfer. Stuart Welch, as elder from the Church of God in Christ.
All right, wonderful. Pastor Stewart, do you want to come on up? We want to ask you these questions for becoming an elder in the Free Methodist Church. Good to see you. Yeah. So when an elder transfers their membership into the Free Methodist Church, we don't reordain. We recognize that Pastor Welch comes to us with a very significant experience in pastoral ministry. So we're not going to reordain him, but we do ask him the questions for elders as he's joining the Free Methodist Church. And I would also just say in the ordination service a little bit later this afternoon, we'll have an opportunity to pray a prayer of consecration over Pastor Welch as he begins his ministry in the Free Methodist Church. But Pastor, welcome.
Thank you.
We're so thankful for you and for your own journey and story that brings you to the Free Methodist Church. So let me ask you these questions that we ask those that are becoming full members of the annual conference. First of all, have you faith in Christ?
Yes.
Amen. Have you the present assurance that your sins are forgiven?
Yes.
Amen. Do you experience purity of heart and life and empowerment for service through the fullness of the Spirit? And will you continue to grow in this experience and so lead your people?
Yes.
Amen. Are you resolved to devote yourself to God and the work to which He calls you, expressing Christian love?
Yes.
Amen. Will you partake of the sacrament of the Lord's Supper when it is offered?
Yes.
Amen. Will you endeavor to effectively communicate the gospel of Jesus Christ?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Amen. Will you see that all people under your care are discipled to be obedient followers of Jesus Christ?
Yes.
Amen. Will you visit ministering to those within and without the church?
Yes.
Will you recommend fasting and prayer both by teaching and by example?
Yes.
And finally, will you endeavor to fulfill the mission and vision of the Free Methodist Church and its ministries in building the kingdom of God?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. So you have heard these answers from Pastor Welch to become a full member of the Sierra Pacific Conference and an elder in the Free Methodist Church. Those of you voting in favor of that, would you raise the hands? Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Any opposed? Looks like looks like it was unanimous. Welcome, brother.
Thank you.
Welcome.
God bless
you. Yeah. Thank you.
That the following persons be received as conference ministerial candidates. Praise Adesida. Turagasu Kabamewa. He is from the Fiji Islands, so you will not see him physically here. Mosese Baledro Kadroka. He's also from the Fiji Islands. Ricky Gail Teote. Ricky is here.
Praise and Ricky. Go ahead and just come up here, line along the front, if you would.
Samisoni Keitu, he's also from the Fiji Islands. Sekope Raikoro from the Fiji Islands. Filimoni Ratoto from the Fiji Islands. Soldad Rosete. Soldad, come over. Where's Soldad? He's not here yet. From San Jose. Tapuai Tachupu Tuamu Vaili. Ilesa Naituku Waile Lakeba. He's also from the Fiji Islands. He's not here.
Okay, is that everyone?
That's everyone for
okay.
CMC.
So one of the really exciting things about receiving these conference ministerial candidates, but also understanding that we have this new work of God in Fiji that is just an exciting development. And so according to Superintendent Mark, these individuals who are not here have been asked the CMC questions already. So after I ask this group, I'll ask you to vote on the group in total. Is that accurate, Superintendent? Okay, very good. All right. So to the four of you and to those that will be watching this later, we just want to say welcome. This step of becoming a conference ministerial candidate is the first step towards ordination, and it's a significant step. Your MEG board has examined your character and the graces of your life, and believe that it is appropriate for you to take this initial step. Obviously, we know you have been on a journey in your own lives in serving Christ and serving the church, but this is a recognition that you are now a candidate for ordination. And so, that the church may hear from you, let me ask you these questions that we ask conference ministerial candidates. Do you acknowledge Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? and offer yourself in service to him as a conference ministerial candidate in the Sierra Pacific Annual Conference of the Free Methodist Church.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. Amen. Recognizing that being a conference ministerial candidate in this annual conference is an important step toward full membership and ordination, do you pledge to equip yourself spiritually, morally, and intellectually for the Christian ministry?
Yes.
Amen. And finally, will you seek and accept the guidance of your superintendent and your Ministerial Education and Guidance Board to fulfill these goals?
Yes.
Amen. Amen. So you have heard the responses to these CMCs who are here present, and then the other names that were read by your MEG chairman. So I'm going to ask you now to vote to receive them as conference ministerial candidates in your conference. All those in favor, would you raise the hand? Thank you. Any opposed? Again, it was unanimous. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Hang on just a moment. Superintendent Mark, let me invite Superintendent Mark, if he would, to come out and pray for them, not only for these who are here, but also these brothers and sisters from Fiji as well. Superintendent?
Indeed. Join me in prayer, please. Heavenly Father, you have embraced with your love these your children. You have, through your Holy Spirit, called them to follow you toward the path of ministry, and indeed each one is serving you with eagerness and willingness of heart. Lord, I thank you for the fruitfulness that has come through their hands, through the teaching, through their spirit-infused mind, and with hearts full of the Holy Spirit, the love that they have already demonstrated. Lord, continue to keep them strong here in the States and in Fiji. Lord, grant them grace to lead and to serve in a way that brings glory and honor to your holy name. Wrap them in your love, we pray. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, I want you to hear from them, and it's important that you make sure and know who they are and where they're from. And so we're going to ask you to respond to one of two questions, okay? So the first one is, do you have a life verse that you would share? Or secondly, you know, if you could put on a t-shirt in front of you, what would be the theme of your calling in ministry? What would that be? So go ahead, brother. I'll put you on the spot here.
Put me on the spot. Yes.
Microphone.
Hello, everybody. Thank you. It's a pleasure and honor to be here. My name is Tapuai Vaili. And the verse that carries me is that Micah 6, verse 8. Mm-hmm. What does the Lord require of me? To act justly.
Amen.
Love mercy. And walk humbly with God.
Amen.
And thank you. I look forward to it. And I'm from the beautiful island of Samoa. Not as nice as Fiji, but still good. Anyway, and we're in San Mateo. We're right now in Redwood City. Amen. Looking forward to it. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. Go ahead.
Yeah, good morning, everybody. My name is Soledad Rosete. I'm coming from San Jose. I'm leading the church Oasis, San Jose. And, well, the Lord called me, and I didn't want it, but I'm here. And I say, okay, use me, God. And my verse touched my heart and always healed me. It is Joshua 1:9. Oh, my goodness, that one. So that's it. I just healed.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, family. My name is Ricky Ngaoteote. I'm going to take the later question since these two have taken the first question. And the second question was, if you had a plain t-shirt, what would stand out or what's the message? I'm going to cheat a little bit and I'm going to say emerging victoriously.
Amen.
That's it. And I shared this a little bit in my testimony for the AC21 about having second chances. That is Jesus Christ. And even though that I've known Jesus Christ all my life, I've been given second chances over and over and over again. And I know all of you can resonate to that. So I'm so proud. I'm so happy. I'm so honored. I'm so excited to be in this part of the group of AC21. Thank you so much, family.
Wow, wonderful.
My name is Praise Adesida.
Is that for the ordination service?
Thank you. And I do have a favorite verse, so I'm going to go ahead and share that one. So my favorite verse is Isaiah 41:31, that those who wait upon the Lord shall have new strength. They shall rise up on wings like eagles, Amen. Run and not grow weary, walk and not be faint. That has literally been my lifelong verse, because both physically and spiritually, it has been a race and a trial. And there's still much more to go, because God is good. So I praise God for that.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Well, in the process, you just received also a number of ministerial candidates from Fiji, and we have a video that we want to show so you can see their faces and hear from them.
My name is...
Yeah, why don't you go ahead and sit down. Thank you.
I thank the Lord for this opportunity to testify the goodness of God in my life so that we can... I give my life to the Lord. I made a decision to give my life to the Lord when I was 15 years old. And in 1999, I made a decision to be a missionary. I always occupied myself to be a missionary in villages, preaching the crusades, where God has used my life with a healing ministry. And I thank God that He used my life for that season to be a missionary and take the gospel throughout every churches, every villages. Also, I went to the country of Australia, and I thank Almighty Jesus for His power, for His anointing. From last year, the Lord has spoken in my heart that I have to join the Free Methodist Church in September. And I thank the Pastor Seven Yadataka, also Mark Adam, Jim Crawford, for the lessons of Israel politics about the church, the Methodist Church, as in my life, knowledge, my interior. Also, I thank the Free Methodist Church, and I believe that God will use me, the Free Methodist Church, not only in Fiji, on the globe, especially for the care of His Gospels in these last days. And I wish all the best for the Free Methodist Church in this global conference, in Seattle Pacific Conference. Thank you so much.
This is Ambulo Binaka, and hello. My name is Moses Mbalin Rokonroka. I'm 47 years old. I'm married with three daughters, and I am a Fijian citizen. My family and I were invited to attend a free Methodist church service. We agreed that we'll seek the Lord's guidance in our decision. After 2 weeks of praying and pondering on His word, the Lord spoke to me, saying, "Hold on and grab the opportunity." He spoke again in His word, Jeremiah 29:11-13. "I know the plans I have for you. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. You will call upon me and come and pray. I will listen to you. You will seek me. You will find me when you seek me with all your heart." And Vinakabaka Lebu, thank you very much. May God bless us all.
My name is Seko Perekoro. I'm 52 years old, married and blessed with 5 children. Back in the 90s, I used to sing nightclubs, hotels, just to entertain people. I drink and I took drugs to help me in every rough situation I go through. In year 2003, I made a decision to surrender everything and receive Jesus to my life. I came to know about the existence of the Free Methodist Church through Sefanet attack. I am so honored to have become a part of the Fijian Free Methodist Church, USA, here in Fiji. Abigbina Wolebu to Superintendent Mark Adam, Jim Crawford, Sefanet attack. To the member of MEC Board, thank you, especially to Sister Immaculate and Sister Mayan. God bless you.
Bula, I am Filimoni Rototo from the island of Fiji, and I just want to testify the goodness of our Lord. Back in 2017, in the month of October, my wife received a call from Sefanet attack. From that relationship, we able to connect and build up that trust to plant this church in Fiji. With the leadership of the Holy Spirit by faith, me, my wife and children was able to start our own house church at our home with the support of Pastor Sefanet Ataka. Through this house church, we were able to create our own war room, prayer war room, that carry us through from day after day until 2020. Announced to have our first lockdown for COVID-19 crisis. That doesn't stop us from meeting. Few months later, we were called to meeting. We were informed by Sefanet attacker to call a meeting to meet up with Mr. Mark Adams. So it is a highlight in my life to journey with all, with you all, that enable holiness, that encourage us to name our ministry Wesley First Free Methodist of Fiji. And I also thank the MEC Board for my first interview, which was successful, which enabled me to join the Sierra Pacific family. Vinakwadi.
My name is Kurang Sau Gambemaiwai. You can call me Sau in short. It is simple. I am from the Fiji Island. I am a teacher by profession. And my role in the Fiji Free Methodist Assistant Senior Pastor of the church. I was brought up in a Christian family. We have nothing where my parents, they were both unemployed. We live in a thatched roof house. The hardship, the challenges that we have to go through day in and day out. I thank the Lord that my parents taught us to know Jesus and to believe in Him and to live by His principle. As to date, and I agree with the Free Methodist Church beliefs, they believe in the Kingdom of God. They believe in the return of Christ. They also believe in resurrection. And I agree with the Free Methodist belief on final judgment. I also like to acknowledge the idea by the Free Methodist Church on the woman to be ordained. They are called by God and blessed by God. Also acknowledge and like the Free Methodist Church for their advocate on the slavery and the human trafficking around the world today. Praise the Lord for that. I think and I believe that it is now time that we act upon what we believe and what the Lord wants us to do.
Praise the Lord. Bulovinaka from Fiji. My name is Ilias Anaituku Welela Kemba. I come from the village of Undu on the island of Kambara in the Lauku. I am 44 years old. I am married and I have three beautiful kids. I came to know Free Methodist through my former senior pastor, Mr. Wesile Welela Kemba. And I was so privileged enough that I went through training through Pastor Mark Adam, Pastor Jim Crawford, and Pastor Sefanaya Tataka. And I am thankful for the MEG board. And I believe that everything happens according to God's plan. So I pray and I say in the name of Jesus that may His will and His purpose and His blessing will happen to you and me and be fruitful in every way that we are living on this earth. So thank you very much. God bless you all. Amen.
I want to dedicate one song to all the candidates of the Sierra Pacific Conference and all the members of the Free Methodist Church in USA. God bless you all.
I will follow Jesus everywhere I go. In times of happiness, though in times of trouble, mountains and valleys, I will follow Thee, because You are my everything. I will follow my Jesus. I will follow every day. Whatever the life I face, trials and temptations, I will follow You, my Lord. There's a road I follow, led by God. People may question a decision I made. I will never turn back, never give up. Jesus is the one who set me free. I will follow my Jesus. I will follow every day, whatever the life I face, trials and temptations, I will follow You, my Lord. Ooh, I will follow You, my Lord.
Praise the Lord. Isn't it wonderful to see how the Holy Spirit connects people? Amen. We're going to do something for our Fijian brothers and sisters since they can't be here personally or participate today in the flesh. We're going to welcome them and we're going to take a video. Thank you, Aaron, digital communications director. And we're going to take a video of you welcoming them. And I'd like Stephaniah to talk. Are you here? Is Stephaniah in the house?
Yeah,
okay. Yeah, come on up. You can get a picture too. Facing down. Everybody give it up for Pastor Stephaniah Tataka. Who knew that during a pandemic that you could start an entire movement in a completely different nation? Who knew? He knew. The Ministerial Appointments Committee, or just to let the cat out of the bag, is appointing Stephaniah as the assistant superintendent to Fijian Ministries. Give it up. All right, now here's what I want to do. You can probably edit as necessary. Get your video ready. Everybody stand up. And I'm going to have you repeat after me. Are you ready? When I say a word, you say it back. Bula bula.
Bula bula.
Bula
bula.
Bula bula.
Bula vanaka.
Bula vanaka.
We welcome you.
We welcome you.
Our brothers and sisters.
Our brothers and sisters.
Throughout the islands of Fiji.
Throughout the islands of Fiji.
To the Free Methodist Church.
To the Free Methodist Church.
Bula.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you very much. You may be seated and know that through your prayers, through your support, and through the hard work of called and apostolic leaders, ain't no pandemic stopping the work of Jesus.
Wow.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, that's wonderful. So exciting to see this. You know, you probably are aware you have a rookie bishop. So, like, some things are supposed to happen in sequence. For those of you who've been here a long time, you're thinking, boy, he got a little confused. So first of all, Pastor Stewart, I owe you an ordination parchment that recognizes you becoming and transferring your ordination into the Free Methodist Church. I will get that to you, I promise. So thank you for your grace. And then I have certificates, which we always do in this session, for the conference ministerial candidates. So let me get those to you. Soledad, first of all, where are you? Thank you, congratulations. Ricky, where is Ricky? Ricky, okay. Okay. There you are, sir. Congratulations. And praise? Where's praise? Okay. Congratulations. Thank you. And Bailey? Yes. There you are. Congratulations. Okay. All right, Pastor Immaculate, we'll go back to your report.
Pastor Stewart is going to Modesto. Modesto Free Methodist Church.
That is not a highly kept secret, is it? Go ahead, Pastor.
Praise the Lord. Now, the following persons will be continued as conference ministerial candidates. And these are Divine Adesida, Galen Meyer, Kevin Cano, Jason Santos, Sue Hall, Darlene Taylor, Miranda Johnson, Judine Thompson, and Laurie Coons.
All right, so you have the recommendation from your MEG board that these be continued as conference ministerial candidates for another year. All those in favor, would you raise the hand? Thank you. Any opposed? And that is approved.
That the following persons be discontinued as conference ministerial candidates: Irene Bazan and Erin Lackey.
All right, thank you. That does not require action, so yes. That's just a report.
That the following persons be admitted into full membership and ordained as elders: David Burns.
So we'll be celebrating David's ordination, the ordination service, a little bit later this afternoon. But in preparation for that, we asked David the questions to become a full member of the conference, and then he will be ordained this afternoon. So David, let me ask you these questions. Have you faith in Christ?
I do.
Amen. Have you present assurance that your sins are forgiven?
I do.
Do you experience purity of heart and life and empowerment for service through the fullness of the Holy Spirit? And will you continue to grow in this experience and so lead your people?
Yeah.
Amen. Are you resolved to devote yourself to God and the work to which He has called you, expressing Christian love?
Yes.
Will you partake in the sacraments of the Lord's Supper when it is offered?
I will.
Will you endeavor to effectively communicate the gospel of Jesus Christ?
Yes.
Amen. Will you see that all the people under your care are discipled to be obedient followers of Jesus Christ?
Yes.
Will you visit ministering to those within and without the church?
I will.
Will you recommend fasting and prayer, both by teaching and by example?
Yes.
And finally, will you endeavor to fulfill the mission and vision of the Free Methodist Church and its ministries in building the kingdom of God?
I will.
Amen. Amen. So in the ordination service, I'll ask David just to share a word of testimony, recognizing those who have been significant on his ordination journey. But it's an important step. You've heard him respond to the questions. He's been examined by your Ministerial Education and Guidance Board. And so now you need to vote to receive him as a full member of this annual conference. So all those in favor of receiving David Burns as a full member of the Sierra Pacific Conference, would you raise the hand? Yay! All right, thank you. Any opposed? And it looks like it's unanimous again, David. Congratulations. Yeah. Well, we'll look forward to celebrating your ordination a little bit later this afternoon, but Superintendent Mark, would you pray?
God, we give you thanks and praise for raising up leaders in our midst. We thank you that you have placed the Holy Spirit with power upon your servant David, that he has, in every way that I can see, become an earnest Christian, living out the values of the Lord Jesus Christ, grounded in the Word of God. Continue to allow him to grow in his faith, to stretch, and to move with others as he leads them into faith in your Son, Jesus Christ, making disciples who make disciples. When he's down, encourage him. When he's alone, bring friends to him. As he leads, grant him courage and wisdom, and fill him with your love. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Congratulations.
Mr. Chairman, the MEG Board recommends that the following persons be given a certificate of standing with view to transfer: Joshua Hemingway, CMC to River Conference; Brock Hoyer, Elder to River Conference. Timothy Tyree, Elder to Fellowship of Christian Assemblies in New York.
All right, so these are elders in your conference that are transferring and comes with a recommendation of your MEG board. All those in favor of granting these transfers, would you raise the hand? Any opposed? All right, thank you. It is so ordered.
The following persons be licensed pastors, none. Now the following transfers have been completed. Joshua Hemingway, CMC to River Conference. Brock Hoyer, Elder to River Conference, and Timothy Tyree, Elder to Fellowship of Christian Assemblies in New York.
Okay, thank you. That's just the report.
Voluntary withdrawn through loss of contact, Paul Koval, Elder. That the following persons be located, none. That the following persons continue to be located, Nolan Hoyer, Elder Tulloch. Thorson Carl, Elder Tulloch.
All right, thank you.
The Ministerial Education and Guidance Board reviewed and affirmed the character of the located deacons and located elders, with the exception of none. The Ministerial Education and Guidance Board has considered the character and performance of all ordained ministers and affirms the integrity and Christian discipleship of the ministerial members of the conference, with no exception.
All right, very good. Thank you so much.
That is the end of my report.
All right, thank you. Yeah, let's maybe hold on for 1 second if you can, Pastor. Let's go back to the question about Curtis Fleming. I wanted to make sure that we don't forget that.
Yeah, well, during COVID year, last year, things aren't altogether clear. Curtis Fleming is a Free Methodist elder who had been leading our church in Oakland, California, the Bay Community Fellowship. 2 years ago, Curtis Fleming asked us to move his ordination status from ordained elder. So he voluntarily withdrew and asked to be a licensed pastor so that he could do dual work with the Church of God in Christ and the Free Methodist Church. And then this last year, his wife Nancy, who is a physician, got a job, I think, in Arkansas. It might be Alabama. It's one of the A states in the South.
But not Alaska,
because it's in the South. I know my geography. Yeah. So, I'm sorry, just playing. She got a great job. They moved, and he's connecting informally with churches in the area. Does that help, Ben? You bet.
Okay.
And he's a good guy who loves the church, and we love Curtis. Changes in status doesn't mean anything other than that.
Hey, let's express our appreciation to Pastor Immaculate and the MEG board.
We have a little bit of fun stuff to do just before lunch, and I'm going to ask a few people to come forward and just to stand up here, if I can find in my notes.